If you are new to catamaran sailing and you really don't know what to expect in different conditions, then you have come to the right place. Because today we're going to be looking at catamaran sailing in all wind strengths. Hello, yes, it's Joe here for Joyrider TV, and today we're doing something quite special. Don't think this has ever been done. Out on a Hobie 16 solo, and what I'm gonna do is sail the boat in all wind strengths. So we're gonna start off with no wind at all or thereabouts, then we're gonna notch it up in perhaps 5-knot increments. So we'll go out later in 5 knots, then in 10, 15, 20, I think you get the idea. We're gonna look at all the different points of sail and how to sail the boat in these different conditions. I've got the Locosys GW60, so we could see what the top speed is in these different conditions. I've also got a Skywatch Explorer 2, so we can see what the exact wind speed is. All right, so let's have a look. Okay, so to get the wind reading fairly accurately, I've put the boat head to wind, so we're definitely not moving forwards. I'm holding the anemometer away from myself and the boat, so hopefully the wind isn't too affected by the boat. It will be affected a little bit, of course, and we are getting 2.4 knots of wind. All right, that's not much. I'd say that is pretty much as light as it gets. We're currently going along at 2.4 knots on the upwind course. Okay, so the way we're gonna break it down is, most importantly, is where are we going? So I would be sailing by looking at the telltales on the jib, but in this wind, there's not actually enough wind to get the telltales to fly, so I'm just looking at the wind indicators on the front of the boat, and we're looking to get those in this light wind roughly at a similar angle to the bottom of the jib. So that is going to be our upwind course in these mega light winds. We're going to sail a little bit freer from the wind than we might do, so a little bit further down, just to make sure that we don't stop if the wind changes direction. Now, I've got almost no tension at all in the main sheet, and I've got just a little bit of tension in the jib to give it some shape. Let's just see what happens if I do bring the main sheet in a little bit. Just really taking it really easy on the main sheet, because oversheeting is really going to kill our speed. All right, so I've got a little bit of tension in the main sheet, and we've notched it up to 3 knots there. So that's pretty good. We're going faster than the wind, that is for sure. I'm now going to see if moving forwards on the boat is going to help our speed at all on this course. Keeping any movements around the boat very small and smooth. Okay. But it really is quite incredible that you can sail along at what feels like a nice pace with zero wind. All right, now the tack is gonna be quite challenging, because the boat is just going to want to stop. So what I'm gonna do is very smoothly move towards the back of the boat. I'm gonna just uncleat the jib there. I'm kind of really trying not to disturb anything on the boat as I move towards the back. Moving quite far back is good, because it's gonna raise the bows, reducing the resistance as we go through the wind, I'm just watching the front of the boat. It is going through. All right, and we are almost all the way through there. I'm actually gonna grab the jib from this side, get the jib set before I move across the boat. Okay, I'm cleaning the main. There's zero tension in the main sheet anyway. So the trick there was just keeping it really smooth. Now I'm gonna have to just persuade the battens to go across a little bit in the mainsail. Okay, that's done. Yeah, so definitely making mouse-like movements around the boat is key in this amount of wind. Okay, so I would say that's the upwind course done. Let's move on to a beam reach. So the wind direction is pretty much from out at sea, even in this light wind, because it's been like this for a long time. Any boats that are anchored are going to point straight into the wind, so you can get a bit of an idea of what the wind direction is. Okay, so we're gonna sail exactly square to the wind, and I'm gonna see if I can persuade the mainsail to go out a bit. I'm gonna use the traveller there to put it out just a little bit. The mainsail has got very little going on at all. All right, we are not going very fast. Just gonna see how moving forwards is gonna affect our boat speed. Again, keeping it very still as we move forwards. Pretty much zero tension in the sails. And yeah, we're not going very fast at all. We're doing like 2.5 knots boat speed maximum. Just trying to let this jib sheet out a bit to make sure it's not affecting our airflow or pulling the jib across. All right, yeah, we notched it up to 3 knots there. I'd say that's pretty good. Okay, 3 knots top speed. Okay, so we're now gonna take it onto a broad reach to see how we're gonna deal with that. But this getting really far forwards is really good because it's reducing the wetted surface, it's lifting the rudders out of the water a little bit, helping us to go along in these mega light winds. All right, so the broad reach, I'm gonna just let the traveller off completely. I'll pull the jib traveller out, just so it might pull the jib outboard a little bit. Just totally freeing the sheets, but I don't want those bad boys in the water. And then on the broad reach in this wind direction, really going as far forwards as we can. We don't even have to hold the stick because there's no pressure in the rudders because we're going so slowly. And to get it going a bit faster, I'll go right to the front, just keeping it on 90 degrees for the tapes at the front here. And then I think we should go for a jibe. What's our boat speed? Oh, we went up to 4 knots there for a second. All right, so again, really tiptoeing around the boat. Not steering too tight into the jibe. Bringing it round. There's one batten that doesn't want to go. Okay, I'm just gonna push the jib through. Let off that jib traveller, pull the other one. and we'll get to our forwards position again on this side, keeping the weight as far forwards as possible at all times on the downwind course in very light winds. Okay, so there we are, light winds or zero, next to zero wind, done. Let's notch it up. Okay, so there we are, we've got 6.5 knots of wind. So let's see how we're gonna sail in this wind strength. Put him away. All right, so we're gonna start off by sailing upwind. Okay, so I've put on enough downhaul to take the creases out of the mainsail. Most important thing is the course, of course, where are we going? So I'm gonna bring the jib in reasonably tight. I've just pulled it in tight and then eased a little bit there. And we're gonna steer the boat by looking at the telltales. Traveller on the mainsail is central. Steering by looking at the telltales. So this is 6.5 knots. I'm just steering by looking at the jib. And as we go faster, our apparent wind speed is of course much faster. In fact, we could just have a quick look at that. Just go do that in this wind. So the apparent wind speed we're getting at the moment is 9 knots. For anybody who's interested. The main sail, we can see we've got a tremendous amount of curve in the main there. Got it in reasonably tight, but not absolutely cranked. I don't want to be stalling the mainsail. As you can see, I'm sat at the front of the trampoline in the corner here. It does feel like if there was a small gust, maybe there's a chance of flying the hull a little bit. Okay, we're gonna go for attack. So, main sheet in tight. We don't have to be quite so ballerina-like moving around the boat now. Just steering up into the wind, watching the jib. When the jib backs, main goes off under the boom. I've totally released the main. Round to the other side. I'll swap the jib over. Okay, nice. Same amount of jib, and always a bit easier moving around the boat with the tiller extension if you actually stand up. Okay, so let's just see what our upwind, what sort of boat speed we can get on the upwind course in this amount of wind. Okay, on the loco sis, we are getting 6 knots boat speed at the moment. There we are. All right, so that's the upwind covered. Now let's take her onto a beam reach. So I'm gonna let the jib off. I'm gonna bring the jib traveler about halfway out. So jib's a bit looser now. Main sheet's gonna go off. I'm gonna let the mainsail traveler out about halfway to the tow strap. So now we're beam reaching. In theory, we should go a little bit faster. Setting the mainsail, we're just looking at the telltales on the mainsail. If the inside ones aren't flying, we can pull it in. If the outside ones aren't flying, we need to let it out. Same goes for the jib. But on the beam reach, generally you choose where you're going and then you trim the sails accordingly. All right, so we did touch 8 knots there for a second. Very speedy indeed in this wind. So unless the wind is incredibly stable, you are going to need to alter the mainsail sheeting reasonably frequently to keep it in the right spot. Okay. Yeah, it's up as much as 8 knots on the beam reach. So we can take it onto a broad reach. So I'm going to let the jib off, jib traveller out all the way, main traveller out all the way as well. And once again, we're going to start steering the boat by watching these telltales at the front. Okay, and once again, I'm going to get to this very far forwards position, because until it gets windy, you'll always go faster on the downwind if you get your weight really far forwards. Okay, not particularly quick here, so 4 knots boat speed at the moment. All right, better go for a jibe. So once again, just going into the middle of the boat at the back. Stick goes across to the new side first. We push it, guide the traveller across. Look forwards as soon as possible, especially if you are sailing amongst flocks of windsurfers. Okay. Jib traveller out on the new side. Small amount of tension in the jib sheet. We want the jib to be out quite far. Main out quite far as well. And then we'll get into our far forwards position. Oh yeah, this is feeling better now. I didn't have, the main traveller hadn't gone out enough on the other tack. So we're now doing 6 knots on this downwind course. Watching these tapes at the front, this goes for any wind strength. If the tapes start coming back towards you, it means we need to turn more downwind. If they start going away from you, so means the wind is more from behind, then we turn up to keep them on 90 degrees. So we really are just focusing on these tapes, keeping them going straight across the boat at 90 degrees. All right, so there we go. I think it's time to notch it up to the next wind strength. Okay, so we're now getting 9.0, gusting up probably to about 10. So let's have a look and see how she's gonna go in this amount of wind. It does look like it's gonna get a bit stronger just up ahead. We can see the water is a bit shinier, and with this sun, that would generally mean a bit more wind. But let's put her in gear and see what we can find. Okay, I think it is a little bit stronger already, probably up to as much as 13 knots of wind here. So we're just starting off by sailing upwind. I'm not gonna go quite as far forwards now in this wind strength. Got the jib in quite tight, and our course, we're just starting to allow the inside telltale on the jib to lift a little bit for that wind strength so we can control the power. The main sheet, I think we have got quite a lot of power there. So if I sheet the main in, yeah, we can. We're into the realms of flying the hull here. So we could sail along with the hull in the air, or we could go out on the trapeze. It's not essential in this wind strength to use the trapeze, but there we are, we're really flying a hull there. So I think I'm gonna go out. Okay, now I'm out on the trapeze. I'm getting reasonably far forwards, pulling the main sheet in as tight as possible, and just looking for the gusts. Very nice. Okay, so I'm gonna come in, and we're gonna look at attack. All right, of course, we do want to have the main sheet in good and tight
before the tack.
All right, so I've got that cranked in. To accept the extra power, I'm just gonna sail closer to the wind. And then when I'm ready to go, I'm gonna check the area, nothing there. And then gonna push her through, letting the main sheet off when we head to wind. Jib's pulling us round. Okay, now we're through the wind. Just gonna pull the jib over. Okay, and I get the feeling the wind has come up a little bit more. Maybe it's more like 14 now. 10 knots isn't something we get for such a long time here. Okay, now if we look at the beam reach, let's see how fast she'll go in this wind strength. So I'm gonna put the jib traveller out actually all the way because I'm feeling quite well powered. Main traveller to the tow strap and then the beam reach. We're assuming the wind is coming straight off the hill there, but we can see the direction of the small waves. And we're just getting those to hit the boat kind of side on. Okay, and I'm gonna go out onto the trapeze, because making sure I'm hooked on. Okay, cranking her in. Let's see how fast we can go on the beam reach. Woohoo, plenty of power. 16 knots there. I think the wind has picked up a bit. All right, now I'm gonna take it onto a broad reach. We've seen the beam reach before, so I don't think we need to dwell on that too much. Coming back into the boat. And once again, the same as in the other wind conditions, we're letting the traveller out a bit more. So it's kind of, I don't know, about a foot from the end of the track. And we're gonna sail the boat by watching these tape wind indicators on the front. Most importantly, where are we going? All right, I'm just sailing a course between some moored yachts. So if we get an area of stronger wind, we're gonna go faster, which means the tape is gonna come back, which means we need to turn more downwind. If we sail into an area of less wind, the opposite will happen, which means we have to turn more towards the wind to maintain that apparent wind direction. All right, so we're gonna go for a jibe. So I'm gonna get into the middle of the boat, body facing the back, checking the area, stick to the new side. Gonna push the stick, grabbing the main sheet there with my hand, continuing the turn through the jibe. Then I need to sort the jib out on the new side. And there we have it. Very nice. Okay, so we've got some more wind now. There we go, she's up to, I've got the boat parked, 15.5 knots. All right, this is when single-handed sailing on the 16 gets interesting. Of course, in any real coastal venue, when we get this much wind, we'd usually get some waves associated with it. But here in Vasiliki Bay, it's very much like a lake. And the water stays flat, even when it's windy. All right, so I'm gonna put the traveller just outside the tow strap. I'm gonna bring the downhaul on more. And in fact, in this wind, single-handed, I'm gonna max the downhaul out and put on as much as there is. All right, there we go. Okay, now let's see what she's got in this amount of wind. Gonna pull the jib in reasonably tight. Got the traveller just outside the tow strap. Hooking on, definitely trapezing in this wind is a good plan. Okay. So now with a single-handed on the upwind, because I don't want to have the jib in so tight that if we get a gust, it'll capsize us on the jib. But maybe we can try cranking it in a bit more. All right, that's the jib cranked. And I'm getting quite far forwards on the side, because once it gets a bit windier on the upwind, the wind is trying to lift the front of the boat out of the water because of all the forces. Wind blowing on the sails, the mast, under the trampoline, everything is lifting the bow. So we're getting forwards on the upwind to counteract that. All right, so I'm gonna go for a tack. Gonna take it a little bit leisurely. So I'm gonna come in first, bit of a wind shift there. And before we go, what I'm gonna do is just ease the jib off a bit, just to make sure that the jib doesn't capsize us. Gonna bring the traveller in a little bit. Checking the area, it's good. So now cranking in, initiating the turn under the boom. Jib's pulling us round. Very nice, thank you, jib. And now we can swap the traveller over, the jib over, sorry, on, just on the sheets there. Gonna let the traveller out a little bit more on the main again. And hooking on, and off we go. I'll make sure the jib sheet is quite close to the edge of the boat, just so that if we do need to adjust it, we've got that ability. By the way, we're out in the Zero Shoes Colorados, still going strong a year and a half later. Very nice. All right. So we're getting some bigger gusts here, maybe up as much as 17 knots. So I'm steering the boat and using a little bit of main sheet to control the power on the upwind here. So if we get a big gust, easing a bit of main sheet and steering up. If it's a smaller gust, then just steering up. But now it's time to go onto that beam reach. Gonna ease the jib off. Gonna leave the traveller in the same position. It's already out quite a way. Now we're gonna steer downwind. And off we go. So this is just a pure beam reach. It's not a Joyrider TV speed run where we keep going deeper and deeper. Top speed here, 18.7. Woohoo! All right. Okay, I'm now gonna come onto the boat so that we can go onto our broad reach, easing the sheet as I come in. Traveller out, ease the jib off a bit more, staying back now until we get settled. There we are, settled, and I can come forwards a little bit more, watching out for foiling wind surface, of course. Good times always in Vasiliki Bay. All right, so I'm gonna go beyond these yachts and then we'll go for the jibe. This wind is coming up beautifully this afternoon. Bit of a gust, so I'm gonna steer more downwind. If that gust goes, I'll bring it back up a little bit there. Best time to jibe is just once you've accepted the speed from the gust. I'm gonna bring the traveller into the tow strap for the jibe. That means the boom will go across a little bit earlier, which makes it easier to carry the speed into the jibe. All right, so when we're going into the jibe, most important is that we don't slow down the rate of turn going in there. All right, just going past one of these wing foilers, good idea to really check your area before you go. Bit of a gust there. Okay, that's a nice gust, we'll go on that one. So going into the middle, stick around, grab the main sheet, put it across. Changing the jib over. Traveller back out on the main, lovely. So one thing I did there on the jibe was as soon as I knew that the boom was coming across, I straightened up the rate of turn. But it's important not to straighten up before the boom comes across. It wants to be just immediately afterwards. In fact, let's just go for another one here. So, traveller into the tow strap and going in, stick to the new side, grabbing the main sheet, straightening up. And that straightening up just takes the sting out of it a little bit, so it's a little bit less violent on the exit of the jibe. Very nice. There we go. There are some examples of sailing upwind, tacking, sailing downwind, and jibing in different wind conditions. So if you're new to Joyrider TV, then you could subscribe. There's a lot of catamaran sailing tutorial videos coming in the summer, pretty much every day. Then in the winter, what we do is once a week, we have a Q&A session every Friday at 4 o'clock Greek time. You can tune in, ask me questions, and I'll give you the answers. Thanks very much. See you next time with some more on Joyrider TV.